what's weird about kind of the spiritual path is I feel like I'm on the path, but I always feel like my friends are just a little farther along than I am. And like suddenly their spiritual conversation has become incompatible with my normal conversation because there's nothing to fix. I heard myself say, oh, I hear you're a little down. I guess I hope you feel better if that's what you want, unless you're just being with it until it's just time to be with something else. So I guess have a good day, or I don't know, have a day. Plus, you can actually be a spiritual master and still be an emotional idiot. I was seeing this ultra-spiritual French guy in India, and he was like, the non-doer in me really wants to do you right now. What? I want to be one with you physically. I'm like, what, emotionally you're good? Spirit? It's like he was saying spiritually can stay over there in your duality. But physically, let's remove the boundaries between you and my penis. No, it's weird. Awakening and coming are actually really similar. In that, the thing that stops them from happening is thinking. You can't force them to happen. You can't... So I was laying in bed the other morning. I was meditating. And I was like... Of course... I was like, oh my God, I am waking up. Woo! Wow, I am waking up! Woo! I am so awake! Wow, who am I? Oh, there really is no I. I'm so shit, I forgot to move my car. Not gonna awaken right now. Being is overstimulated. Have you guys done ayahuasca? Yeah. You're drinking the Kool-Aid. A lot of my friends are doing the plant medicines these days. There's this weird experience where they want to let you know that their plant medicine is better and scarier than yours. When the whole idea is communion and oneness.